a cop gave an unsheltered man a sandwich that contained human excrement. What if I said that? You would say, oh, no way. What if I told you this is a problematic cop who had other issues in his past that spoke to his sick and depraved mind, and he was still allowed to be a cop? Let's put his picture full mass here. Matthew Luckhurst, a Texas cop who first lost his job in 2016 after giving an unhoused man a feces sandwich. You heard me correctly. He has been fired by a second Texan police department. The San Antonio police indefinitely released this cop for the sandwich incident. He was later hired by the Floresville Police Department. There's more. Floresville police said the officer had been working as a reserve officer for the city, having been signed on a few months after he was let go from the San Antonio Police Department. According to the mayor, reserve officers don't work full time. This is them trying to minimize their responsibility. They are not paid and serve as volunteers. But the city was apparently unaware of his history of alleged misconduct. So let me explain this volunteer dynamic. You're still supposed to submit to a background check. That's part of the requirement. You still have to engage in good faith disclosure about any problematic issues you may have. All of this is required. And the city can just Google your name and this will come up. They did none of that, obviously. Let's put up the picture of the mayor. So you have Floresville Mayor Gonzalez Dipple on the right. Said there has been an outpouring of emails from locals who were unhappy about Luckhurst being reemployed as an officer. Wait a minute, it took people who are not paid by the government to tell you what the government should have known initially. That's exactly what happened. The mayor said in a statement from last week, and I quote, Matthew Luckhurst was released from employment. Wait a minute, ma'am, I thought you said it was a volunteer action. All right, released from employment with the Floresville Police Department yesterday, December 13th, our city manager, Andy Jocelyn, is implementing stricter hiring policies for all city of Floresville employees. He is also working with the Chief Harara, on the reserve program. So you got the Floresville Chief of Police, Lorenzo Harara. You have that he's in the center. The department released a statement on Facebook on December 13th. Everybody's now trying to figure out how to clean it up. That started by addressing the concerns raised by Lockhurst hiring and emphasized his position as a reserve officer. So it says in the statement, unfortunately, the Floresville Police Department was not fully aware of the entire incident involving the alleged incident, as the same individual had previously been issued a general discharge by the previous law enforcement agency. And FPD does not condone any of the alleged actions, but rest assured they do not condone the alleged actions and will do whatever is necessary to ensure the continued safety of its citizens. Okay, so there's an element of truth here. And the truth is, the officer is right, the deputy or the chief is correct. Why? Because the cop received a general discharge. They could have decertified the guy. They could have fired him with an explanation. They could have literally called Post, which is your certification outfit. They could have called Post and said, do not certify this guy again to ever be a cop, and here's why. But they did none of that. There's more. Backstory per the insider. The officer, Luckhurst, was first terminated by the San Antonio police in 2016 after an internal investigation determined that he placed feces between slices of bread and gave it to a homeless man while on duty. That's according to KSAT. The police officer won an appeal over the feces sandwich incident due to a local government code that prevents officers from being disciplined or conduct occurring over 180 days ago. There's more. There was another feces related incident. He was later given a second indefinite suspension following an investigation into a separate incident in which he allegedly failed to flush feces down a toilet in the woman's restroom at the downtown bike office, a bike patrol office, spread a brown-like substance on the seat. Luckhurst took responsibility for the toilet incident, but said it was a prank and apologized. In hindsight, it was immature, he said at a hearing. However, he did not win his appeal against the toilet incident. The arbitrator assigned to the case decided that SAPD chief was justified in terminating him, citing the egregious nature of the conduct aimed at women. So let's get this straight, okay? He gives a human being a feces sandwich who happens to be unsheltered, which means he doesn't have a lot of influence over the police department for sure. No biggie, he is allowed to remain. But he does a prank and he is let go. Now naturally, both are bad. I think we all can agree that getting a sandwich of feces and you're unsheltered and hungry, now damn it, that's just evil, right? He should have been arrested for that. They want to hide behind the 180 days. Please understand, he could have been arrested for that. He was not. All right, so that's the development of the story. My dear brother, thoughts here.
Everything about this story is insane. This story is a feces sandwich that was allowed to occur. It's unreal. Several things. First of all, these statutes protecting police officers. His argument is literally, yes, I did almost poison a man in the most demoralizing, dehumanizing way possible by giving him a feces sandwich to eat. But in my defense, it was over 6 months ago. That's the defense? That happened over 6 months ago. So what's the problem? Then no one even mentions in the incident that did get him released, the fact that he was in the woman's restroom. What's he doing using the woman's restroom, let alone spreading brown tapioca on the toilet seat? And only in retrospect did he realize it was immature. He thought it was very mature at the time. This is what an officer of the law should be doing, pulling pranks in the women's restroom after using it creepily. But thinking back on it, I could have used better judgment. Then the Floresville department says that they will now be using stricter hiring practices. How are strict hiring practices not part of your approach from day one?
Exactly.
Your plan is let's let officers who are disgusting, immoral human beings serve on our reserves until there's an outcry. Then maybe let's crack the whip a little and tighten it up. That's your move? That's the time that you decide to step up the way you do things? It's a disgusting thing in all respects. And finally, Floresville made sure they put out the announcement, clearing everything up, saying, we do not condone this behavior. Could you imagine if they came out saying they did condone it? Normally we do condone feces sandwiches, but just not this time. That's too little too late, saying you don't condone disgusting behavior. The man, as you said, should have been arrested for demoralizing a human being. The fact he was put on another police force for even a day, even as a reserve, is disgusting. And people should be fired for it.
That's
like
right.
You said, Google's right there at your fingertips.
Yeah, somebody in the city should have been held accountable. It doesn't seem as if they were. And you're right. Them saying, oh, we completely disagree with what he did. Of course.
Wow, what a revelation.
Exactly.
What a revelation.
Right. Okay.